Hello everybody, today we're going to make musical symbols. Inflate a balloon leaving about 8, maybe 9 cm flat tail. Twist the first and the second about 3 cm long bubbles. Lock all ends of the first two bubbles in one lock twist. The first symbol I am making is a half note. As always, I'm using only 260s balloons to make all balloon sculptures. And also I give only very approximately estimated size of all bubbles. Twist the third about 25 cm long bubble. Lock both ends of the third bubble in one lock twist. Shape the third bubble. The hole in the loop of the third bubble should be very visible. Otherwise it will look like a quarter note. Basically, we already made the half note. We can make the staff of the note shorter. Let's twist the fourth bubble about 30-40 cm long. Cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the end. Congratulations, we have made the half knot. We can use scissors to trim off the end of the balloon. The quarter knot you can make basically in the same way. Now I'm going to make a quarter or eighth knot. Inflate a balloon leaving about 8 cm flat tail. Twist the first and the second about 3 cm long bubbles. Lock all ends of the first and the second bubbles in one lock twist. Now let's make the third about 20 cm long bubble, up to 25 cm long bubble. Lock both ends of the third bubble in one lock twist. We have made the quarter knot. We can make it look even better. Let's twist the fourth bubble. Let's make the fourth bubble about 25-30 cm long. Lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. Fix the third bubble inside of the loop of the fourth bubble. We have made a quarter knot. I'm going to use the rest of the balloon to make this knot look like a quarter or eighth knot. Twist the fifth about 30-40 cm long bubble. Then we twist the sixth and the seventh about 3 cm long bubbles. Lock all ends of the sixth and the seventh bubbles in one lock twist. The rest of the balloon is the eighth bubble. If it's too long, you can make it shorter. I'm gonna leave it as it is. You can bend the eighth bubble to shape it properly. Congratulations, we have made the eighth knot. In the following example, I'm going to make beamed knot. Inflate a balloon leaving about 8-10 cm flat tail. Twist the first two about 3 cm long bubbles. Lock both ends of the first and the second bubbles in one lock twist. As you may notice, I work all knots in the same way. Of course, we can change the order of twisting bubbles and even change size of bubbles. Twist the third about 20 cm long bubble, lock both ends of the third bubble in one lock twist. Twist the fourth about 25-30 cm long bubble, lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. Fix the third bubble inside of the loop of the fourth bubble. You have to make one more knot in the same way. I have already prepared in advance. I made one knot slightly smaller size than the other one. You can see the balloons have a slightly different length, and the flat tails have different size as well. You can make them of the same or different sizes, it's not a big deal. First I'm going to work with a long balloon. Let's twist the fifth about 35, maybe 40 cm long bubble. It is how tall our sculpture is going to be. Now let's twist the sixth about 3 cm long bubble. Lock both ends of the sixth bubble in one lock twist. Now I'm going to make the beam. Let's twist the seventh about 20-25 cm long bubble. twist the eighth about 3 cm long bubble. The rest of the balloon is the ninth bubble. It should be no less than 10 cm long. Now take the second balloon. Let's twist the fifth about 25-30 cm long bubble. Then let's twist the sixth and the seventh about 3 cm long bubbles. Lock all ends of the sixth and the seventh bubbles in one lock twist. I'm making the second knot shorter than the first knot. It is shorter than the first knot on the length of the ninth bubble of the first knot. Pinch the end of the first balloon, the free end of the ninth bubble of the first balloon, and lock it between the sixth and the seventh bubbles of the second balloon, right here. The total length of the ninth bubble of the first balloon and the fifth bubble of the second balloon should be about the same as the length of the fifth bubble of the first balloon. You can make the knots of the same size or slightly different, it's okay. Now I'm going to make the second beam. Let's twist the eighth bubble of the second balloon. We should make it of the same size as the first beam, the seventh bubble of the first balloon. Now I twist the ninth and the tenth, about 3 cm long bubbles of the second balloon. Lock all ends of the ninth and the tenth bubbles of the second balloon in one lock twist. We don't need the rest of the second balloon. Let's cut it off. You can use scissors to do it. Tie off the end of the second balloon, hide it between bubbles of the sculpture. Now we have to split the fifth bubble of the first balloon on two parts. Let's make the upper part of the same size as the ninth bubble of the first balloon. Lock the ninth and tenth bubbles of the second balloon between parts of the fifth bubble of the first balloon. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations, we have made beamed knot. As you can see, one knot is a bit shorter than the other one. So if I flip the knot the other way, it will have slightly different appearance. Yes, I like this way better. We can use all knots as it is, separately. Or we can hang them on the walls, or even suspend them in the air using thin threads. I like to use thin thread of the same color as the background, it makes it less visible. Also, I'm going to use clear sticky tape, one-sided sticky tape. Let's stick one end of the white thin thread to the wall using clear sticky tape. I think here would be just fine. You hardly can see the thin thread or clear sticky tape even from the close distance. I'm going to use five fully inflated balloons to represent five lines of musical stuff. Let's loop the thin thread around one end of the balloon. Then we step down a bit and attach the second balloon using the thin thread in exactly the same way, and so forth. We have to attach a total of 5 balloons, make 5 horizontal lines. And then I will use the sticky tape to attach the thin thread at the bottom of the wall. We can attach the other side of balloons using thin thread in exactly the same way. Just for an example, I will attach the other end of balloons using clear sticky tape only. You can use double-sided clear sticky tape for the same purpose. Normally it doesn't make big difference whether you use clear sticky tape or thin thread to attach balloons to the walls. However, you may not use sticky tape on some walls. For example, if the wall is very dusty or it's covered with a carpet. Okay, he have made musical stuff to write notes on. In previous instruction I made a musical clef. You can find link how to make this balloon sculpture on my website fewdoit.com. I'm using clear sticky tape to attach a clef to balloons on the wall. Now I'm going to use clear sticky tape to attach the clef and all musical notes that we made today to the balloons on the wall. Congratulations again, we have made musical notes. Please subscribe to my video channels to stay updated. Like my video, share it with your friends, leave comments. Have fun and happy twisting!